Breakfast. I'm going. I thought I'd say goodbye. Gentlemen, again, all the best. Take good care, good luck, and goodbye. It's been fun.
Here you go, sir.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
To see the director of the Secret Service.
Okay, thanks.
Is there any place where I could put my bags?
Yeah, take them right through there.
Thank you.
Okay.
Congratulations, though. You've done a terrific job on a tough detail.
Well, thank you, sir. It wasn't that tough, actually. Somersville, Ohio is not exactly the center of the universe, of course, but it's a nice, quiet little place. And guarding Mrs. Carlisle did give me the time to pick up quite a few more hours towards my master's.
Oh, great.
Of course, now I am hoping for a little more active assignment. Maybe back in the White House.
Uh-huh.
Or a criminal assignment out of New York or L.A.
Sure. Look, why don't we sit over here?
Yes, sir.
Joan?
Yes, sir.
Can we have some coffee, please?
Certainly. It'll be just a moment.
How is she these days? What's she like?
Well, there's the public person who's, you know, adored. And then there's the private person who can, at times, be pretty difficult to deal with if you don't know how to handle a situation.
And you did.
Well, I guess. About as well as anybody, I suppose. I don't envy my replacement, I'll tell you that. On the other hand, I was in her husband's White House, and I saw her in better times. She has her good days and her bad days now. I guess you could say she's several different personalities in one, like many people.
Well, one of her personalities called the White House last night and asked the president if he could arrange for you to stay on with her for another tour.
Yeah. the president. I can't go back there. I can't do 3 more years there. I can't do 3 more minutes there. It's the worst assignment there is in the service.
Well, then we've got a problem. Because the president is asking you to return to Mrs. Carlisle as a personal favor to him.
Well, what if I say no?
I'll call him and tell him you said no. Why don't you take a moment or two to think it over? I'll go check on the coffee.
Where's the Columbus paper? Who's got it?
She's checking my horoscope.
Frederick, I told you 1,000 times she can tell if someone's read it before her.
Got it.
Morning, Doug.
Morning.
What are you doing here?
Long story.
Everything okay in Washington, Doc?
Yeah.
Just back to pick up your accoutrement?
Speak English, Fred.
Just back to pick up your shit?
No smoking, Earl.
Why can't I smoke? She never comes down here.
Doesn't matter. It's a rule.
Well, frankly, Douglas, I, for one, I'm shocked to see you back here.
Are you?
Yeah. I thought you'd be guarding Jackie O by now, standing outside the Russian tea room for hour after hour in the freezing snow when she was inside having one of those lovely little cakes and chatting to her fashionable friend.
Yeah, Frederick.
I'll do it this morning, Fred.
Thank you.
Morning. Breakfast.
Come in.
Douglas, darling.
Yes, ma'am.
Well, you seem to have dropped some of my things on the floor. Would you be kind enough to pick them up for me?
Yes, ma'am.
That's a good boy. Do I still have any influence in that evil little town, or have they forgotten all about me?
Ma'am, with all due respect, why me?
Why? Because I like you, Douglas. And I must say, my feelings are a bit hurt that anyone would be that anxious to get away from me.
Well, I certainly don't mean to hurt your feelings, Mrs. Carlisle, but my assignment here is finished, and I'd like to get back to Washington.
Washington is a dead-end town, Douglas, career-wise. Unless you're there purely to make money, which I'm sure you wouldn't be.
I'd like to go back, Mrs. Carlisle.
Well, I'm sorry, but I need you here.
Mrs. Carlisle?
Yes?
I'd just like you to know that I came back of my own free will. As an SAIC, I could have refused this assignment, but I didn't.
SAIC? What is that?
Ma'am, you know very well what that is.
No, I don't. I really don't.
Yes, you do, ma'am.
Don't tell me what I know and what I don't know, young man. That is not your place. What is a SAIC?
SAIC stands for Special Agent in Charge.
I see. A special agent, are we? And in charge, no less. My. You rarely meet someone who's a secret agent who's also in charge. And why is he in charge? Well, because he's so doggone special. And you did not come back here of your own free will. If you had a free will, you'd be miles from here.
I have some very exciting news for you.
I have an inoperable brain tumor. I have bought you and your men a Scud missile launcher. We are going to the opera in Columbus. Which of those do you think is true?
When?
I would like to drive to Columbus a week from Friday.
Yes, ma'am. May I say, it is good to see you getting out again.
Is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you, Douglas. That's very patronizing of you. I suppose you couldn't care less about opera.
No, ma'am, I couldn't.
Of course not. You're a typical red-blooded American male. You'd probably rather watch the reruns of Mr. Ed on television now, wouldn't you, Doug? Tell me, if you had to choose between opera and Mr. Ed?
I'd choose Mr. Ed in a second.
Oh, you're so honest.
Yes, ma'am, I try to be.
Well, good for you, Agent Dougie. I'll put my rosebud on the tray and get out. As you can see, I'm extremely busy.
I expect him any minute. I'll tell him as soon as he comes in. All right. Goodbye. Hi.
Hi.
She wants to see you.
Oh, come on. I was just up there. She called the president to demand I pull another tour. How do you like that shit?
Why?
Because she likes me. Oh, you don't think that's the reason?
I don't know. Who knows with her?
She didn't say anything about liking me, did she?
Doesn't have anything to do with like. She doesn't want a new guy coming in here, shaking things up, trying to get things running right. She's got me broken in. She'll never let me go.
Doug?
Now my master calls again.
Check this out, you guys. Helen Grace. Helen?
Yes, Peter. In the city of Agua Dulce, when automatic weapon fire broke out shortly after 2:30 local time, the president was immediately hustled from the scene and Secret Service plane.
You see those special tactics guys? They're everywhere.
That had only seconds ago applauded the American leader repeatedly.
Excuse me, Helen. The men we see there with the guns and rifles, are they United States Secret Service agents?
Well, Peter, we believe that.
Tell her I'm busy. I'll be there in
15
minutes.
This will be there in 15 minutes. Many are from our host country.
Is this cool?
Is there any report where the first lady
is? What does she want? Chocolate? Some kind of goddamn fruit drink or something? What do we look like? Waiters? Are we a bunch of waiters? We want to be down there! Some sort of charity work. I got it! I'm coming!
I can't do three more years of this.
Bring a gun in this room. Now get it out.
Yes, ma'am.
How dare you bring a gun in here?
Sorry, Mrs. Carlisle.
It's all right, John.
Mrs. Carlisle, that emergency alarm is to be used
that immediately. That alarm belongs to me, and I will use it by God any time I see fit.
I think it bothers the neighbors. Sorry.
What is it you want, ma'am?
I want to play golf.
What?
Golf. It's a game. My husband and I used to play it. Do you remember that?
Mrs. Carlisle, it's 38 degrees outside.
Thank you, Tom. Could you have the car ready in half an hour?
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you. Now, go on, come on. Shoot, shoot. Go on! Kimberly! Kimberly! Not standing there. No, not there. Go over there where I can see where you are. Didn't you guard Ford or Agnew or those people?
No, ma'am.
All I ever did was play golf.
Yes, ma'am.
Which was a real blessing for the country.
Yes, ma'am. No, I was too young.
What?
I was too young to serve Fort Dragna.
Get back in the cart. Yes, get ma'am. In the cart!
Yes, ma'am.
What is this all about? She sits up in her room for 5 years, and now we've got golf.
And opera.
What's next?
Synchronized swimming.
Why are you making noise? We're trying to putt.
Sorry, ma'am.
Why don't you at least make yourselves useful? If you come and hold the pin.
Yes, ma'am.
Would you be kind enough to get my first ball, please, Doug?
I'm a Secret Service agent, Mrs. Carlisle, not a caddy. You want that ball? I suggest you go get it yourself.
Ralph?
Go. And since you've insisted on me staying here, I think you should know I intend to do my job by the book, which means we don't run errands, we don't make snacks, and we don't check our guns at the door. Now, if you don't like any of this, I suggest you call Washington and get yourself a new man.
I'd be very careful if I were you, Agent. You're way out of your depth.
Let's switch. I've got to go up to the clubhouse.
Sure thing, Doc.
Us gophers with guns, no more snacks in the middle of the night, no more checking our weapons outside your bedroom door.
You said that?
Mm-hmm. In so many words, what I basically said was from now on, we go by the book.
And she stood for this?
She didn't say a thing. Oh, yeah. She tells me to go find her ball. I said, I'm not a caddy. I'm a Secret Service agent. You want that ball, you go find it yourself.
Come on.
What are you, crazy?
No. Let me tell you why. Hello.
Mr. Chesnick?
Yes.
Please hold for the president.
Hello?
Hello?
Hey, you, Doug?
Yes, sir.
How are you?
I'm fine, and you?
Well, I got this call from Tess Carlisle, and I know this sounds a little crazy, but did you tear up some flowers of hers? Doug, you there?
Uh-huh, yes, sir.
Something about a bunch of roses.
Well, no. It wasn't a bunch, sir.
Uh-huh. Well, how many of them were there?
Just one, sir.
I see. And you tore it up, did you?
No, sir. I didn't tear it up.
Well, what'd you do?
I merely removed the bud.
From her flower?
Yes, sir.
Okay, well, let's get past that for a second. As you know, I was her husband's vice president.
Yes, sir.
And frankly, I owe a lot to the Carlisle. She seconded my nomination. I think you know that, too.
Yes, sir.
So, why don't we all try to get along a little better over there in Ohio, Doug? What do you say?
Yes, sir, absolutely.
I don't get it myself. One day she calls me, says she can't live without you. Next day she's calling almost in tears. So, you know, maybe you two have some kind of sicko thing going on.
No, sir. I can tell you that.
I'll tell you this, Doug. Any more phone calls from her and you're going to be guarding my dog. You understand what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Because I probably got the most important job in the world.
Yes, sir.
And I feel like a goddamn idiot having to call you about a goddamn flower. You know what I mean, Doug?
Yes, sir, I do. I certainly do.
So what do you say? You going to help me out on this one?
You,
Yes, you can count on it, sir.
Thanks, Doug. That's what I wanted to hear. You have yourself a nice evening, son.
Yes, sir.
Night.
If you need help, hang up and then dial your operator.
In Albania 231, in Francia, in Turchia 91, in Hispania, in Hispania.
Hey, Mrs. Carlisle, I got you laundry and a wiper.
Who's this opera by again?
Mozart.
Oh, that's right. I saw a movie about him. Guy was a complete jerk. The end of the movie, some guy comes to see him wearing a party mask. I mean, it's just a mask, right? But it upsets Mozart so much that he drops over dead, just like that. What the hell kind of guy is that?
I don't know, Lee.
Here, don't shoot yourself.
Very funny.
Happy hunting. Sorry, ma'am.
This way, ma'am.
Kill the engine.
Start the engine. Earl.
Yes, ma'am.
Do you like your job?
Yes, ma'am, a lot.
Mrs. Carlisle, the protectee is never allowed to sit directly behind the driver. That's a regulation. Nobody does it. Not the president, not anybody.
The sun will be on that side, and I do not want the sun.
Perhaps you could sit on the proper side, but slightly then to the middle. Ma'am, excuse me, but we are not leaving this house until you are seated properly with your seatbelt firmly fastened.
Jesus Christ, let her sit on the hood if she wants to.
Move it out, Earl. We're rolling.
Oh, God, these family outings are always so stressful.
ich gehe, doch rate ich dir, den Schurken Petrillo zu meiden, den Schurken Petrillo zu meiden.
Und was ich mit dir, mit dir, mit dir, mit dir, du weißt, ich kann es nicht leiden, du weißt, ich kann es nicht leiden, ich kann es nicht leiden, ich kann es nicht leiden.
Versprich mir, kein Schritt von der Stelle, kein Schritt von der Stelle, kein Schritt von der Stelle. Bist du so gehorchen, mir schwör, so gehorchen, mir schwör.
Never been so embarrassed in my life. I want to go home. I don't want to go to the hotel, and I will never return to Columbus again.
Yes, ma'am.
For what it's worth, I was just trying to help.
Your help is most precisely what I do not want. When will you people get that?
Write me at this address, and I'll see that you get an autographed picture. Good night, ma'am.
Oh, a picture. How wonderful. A picture. Well, thank you so very much. Very, very nice and wonderful. I hope you enjoyed the opera as much as I did. I've changed my mind. We'll be staying in Columbus tonight.
Yes, ma'am.
Give him hell, Tess.
What do you care what she sits in that damn car?
She's supposed to be where the driver and I can both see her at the same time. Come on, Tom.
Hell, I know that. That's not what I'm asking. This detail's a cupcake. It may be the most boring detail in the service, but it's still a cupcake. So why are you going to risk your career on crap like that?
Because it's not crap. It's my job. I'm either going to do it right, take pride in, or I'm going to find something else to do.
Okay, you're right. I can't argue. But, Doug, I wouldn't piss her off. Couple more phone calls to the White House, and you'll be looking...
Guarding the president's dog.
Bullshit. You'll be gone. You try to get a job out there now. You know what they want, private security? They want guys that can bench press 9,000 pounds. This is a good deal. You've let it get personal.
It's not personal.
Of course it is. She doesn't even know the rest of us are alive, man.
How is she?
Oh, she's fine.
Get rid of those.
Okay.
Hey, what about Ali Tyson?
Ali TKO, eighth round in his prime.
All right, what about Mrs. Carlisle and Nancy Reagan?
In their prime?
Yeah.
Mrs. Carlisle would knock Nancy out in the sixth or seventh round.
Yeah, it wouldn't go the distance?
No. Two completely different fighters. Nancy doesn't have the big-time punch. She throws these cutting left jabs and combinations. Always in your face, unrelenting. Bap, bap, bap. Mrs. Carlisle, she's a floater, a dancer, totally unpredictable. And just when you think you got her where you want her, bam, out of nowhere comes a right hand, and Nancy's on Queer Street. End of fight.
I think you're right about that.
I know I'm right.
I know, that's why I asked you.
Ralph, be a dear and get me a baby Ruth, would you please?
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you. Earl, go.
Mrs. Carlisle, I can't.
Who got you this job, did they or did I?
She took off!
Earl! Earl! I want you to pull over right now, you hear me? God damn it!
I'm sorry, Doug.
It's not your fault, it's my fault. Not your fault. Should have seen it coming. Should have seen.
Aha, well, just hold on a minute. I'm gonna, Agent Chesnick, I'm gonna put you on the speaker.
Is there someone else in the room?
Oh, no. No, I just want to practice my putting while we're talking. What can I do for you?
Would you please put out an all points for Mrs. Carlisle's automobile? It's a 92 Lincoln, Ohio plates, Kilo Hotel Oscar 362.
When last seen, it was heading east on the Chester exit of I-71.
Just hold everything. Have I got this right? Have you Secret Service boys gone and lost the president's wife again?
I don't believe there's any cause for concern here. She's with her driver. She's perfectly safe, but proper procedure requires us to notify you.
Of course it does. We'll get on this right now.
Thank you.
Agent Chesnick, Miss Carlisle is pretty slippery, isn't she? I mean, for a senior citizen. Hello.
Doug, let's have a little stroll around the yard before we go in there and talk to him, okay? Doug?
I want you to go in there and tell Earl to meet me in the office. Okay, Lee?
All right.
Thank you.
Hey, everybody's mad at me, right? Well, what am I supposed to do? I'm just the driver, you know?
Hey! Blue, you know that?
No, I don't know that.
You don't know that!
No, I don't know that.
Why don't you know that? Oh,
Come on! Because she assured me that I was not going to be fired, and in fact, I would have been fired if I hadn't done it. Look. You guys come and go, but I live here, and
I keep my job because of her. Oh, you think I don't try to talk her out of these crazy things, but I got no choice.
Well, you're fired, Earl. Trust me.
Come in.
Did you enjoy yourself today?
Don't take that tone with me, Douglas.
Look, this is just stupid, okay?
Which part? The part where I have to run away like a fugitive in order to have 1 hour's worth of privacy? Or the part where I am spoken to like a child?
I fired Earl. This has happened twice now.
No.
He is a driver in the employ of the Secret Service. I can't do anything about the cook or the nurse. No, they work for you. But this guy works for us, and he's gone!
He works for you because I told you people to hire him. He's my chauffeur. And he's staying!
You've got to let me leave this detail, Mrs. Carlisle. I can't do my job effectively.
Whatever you like. You can go anytime you please.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Goodbye, Mrs. Carlisle.
Goodbye. If I promise never to run away again, will that do?
Ma'am, I am truly sorry, but I...
For God's sake, Doug, I only went for a little drive.
It was a crazy thing to do.
Yes, crazy, exactly. You should try it sometime, Douglas. You should try going crazy yourself. You should get a date. You should have a martini. You should drive with the top down. You should, better yet, give a tired old widow a break.
I am very sorry, Mrs. Carlisle, but the regulations...
Oh, well, fine. Go. Whatever you want to do. Just leave. One less gunman lounging around my house. Take the whole bunch with you.
We are not gunmen, Mrs. Carlisle.
And since I am leaving for sure this time, I'd like to take this opportunity to remind you that you can refuse Secret Service protection anytime you want. I believe you already know that.
Well, that's brilliant, Doug. You think they'd really let me get away with that?
I don't know why not. Other people have done it, but I think you like it. I think you like having 7 men and no women agents, I notice, at your beck and call day and night.
Get a date.
How dare you?
Goodbye, Mrs. Carlisle.
Get out. Get out of my house this instant. And stay out.
Yeah.
This is Air Force One calling. Stand by for the president.
Yes, sir.
How are you?
I'm fine, sir. How are you?
Well, I'm not too good. I'm on my way to London. I'm supposed to be working on a speech for the common market. Instead, I'm having a goddamn Tess Carlisle problem. What the hell's that about, Doug? Do you know that as of this morning, she has refused Secret Service protection? Where the hell did she get an idea like that? This woman is a national treasure. Maybe you and I know what a pain in the butt she is, but we don't count. It's what the goddamn voters think. That's what counts. And they want this woman looked after. You understand me?
Yes, sir.
What if some lunatic breaks into her house and cuts her goddamn throat? What about that?
Well, I agree, sir.
Voodoo, do you think I'd catch if something like that happened on my watch?
Yes, sir.
So let me make it real clear. Get over to her house and straighten this out. I'm counting on you, and so's the country. You hear me?
Yes, sir. I'll get on it right away.
Okay, that's what I want. fun to hear. Thanks a lot, buddy. Hey, the next time you're in town, I want you to come over to the White House and have dinner with us, something like that.
Yes, sir. I'd be honored. I'll be there. Thank you.
All right. Have a nice day, pal.
Yes, sir, I will.
Told us to leave and take the flag with us. I had to load the weapons in the station wagon.
Jimmy.
Hello, that you, Doc?
Yeah, I want you to open the gate.
No way, Doc.
Come on, Jimmy, let me in there. I'm acting on the authority of the President of the United States.
So what, Doc? You got Mrs. Carlisle in here.
Doug.
This is Frederick. I want you to listen very closely. Jimmy and
I are holding Mrs. Carlisle hostage. And here is what we want.
We want $100 in unmarked bills.
And a helicopter. Matching sports coats.
And a video cassette of the movie Gigi. Are you listening to me, Doug?
Hello, Earl.
Doug, can you hear me, Doug?
Earl, do me a favor. Can you talk to Mrs. Carlisle?
You owe me an apology.
Yeah, probably. Can you talk to her?
She hasn't seen anyone.
Okay. Do me a favor. Try to get her to let me in. If she wants to go out, go shopping, anything, please let me know. I'll be in the car.
Okay.
Thank you. Okay, Barbara, I guess you might as well go home. You guys go home, too. Get some sleep. All right, the three of us will take perimeter positions. Lee, you take Maple. Ralph, go around back. We'll take our cars. I'll sit out front. Let's load this stuff up.
This is nuts.
You got a better idea?
Gate's opening. Do you read me?
Yeah, we got you, Doug.
Copy that.
Okay, guys, we're rolling. She's in the town car heading west. Mrs. Carlisle, we need to talk.
I took your advice. I did what you wanted. Now leave me alone. Drive, Earl. Stay with the car, please.
Yes, ma'am. Mrs. Carlisle, I was just on the phone to the president.
Really?
Yes, ma'am. And he said that you should let the...
Get away from me.
Yes.
Doug, this is Ralph. I'm going off duty right now. She hasn't been out of the house all day. By the way, Frederick said that Mrs. Carlisle's son is flying in tomorrow. That's about it from here. Later.
Barry! Oh, hello, my darling! Oh, good to see you. Oh, you look so wonderful.
I miss
You bring in his luggage?
He's okay.
Come. Tell me all about your luggage.
This thing is the best project that I've seen in years, of its nature. Here. What we're talking about is 125 detached and semi-detached retirement villas, starting from $125,000 Venice studio layout, going all the way up to the Tuscany four-bedroom plan, which starts at 799. And at least half of the villas have a view of the nine-hole golf course, designed by Taylor Fry. The whole project's primo, Mom. I mean, you know, it's first class the whole way. The only problem, and I mean, I don't really think of it as a problem. I think of it more like an opportunity, you know what I mean? But some of the management at Topland Properties got burned in the SNL mess that went down a couple of years ago. So what we're looking to do now is to find a way of showing people that we are rock solid. You know, and one of the ways of doing that is to get people of your stature to endorse the project. All we would need would be a letter, just something to use, just in the brochure, saying that you think the project's a good one for older people looking for a sun and recreation type lifestyle. Only downside of the whole thing is the banks being so tight-fisted in Phoenix because they made all those stupid loans. We have got to show people that they can trust the Hacienda Palms concept down the line.
No.
What?
I said no.
Now is exactly the kind of mandate President Carlisle wanted from this convention. This is for all intents and purposes a coronation rather than a nomination. Jim Carlisle is going to get anything and everything he wants from the delegates, who seem ready to follow him into the fight.
Their stay at their home in Somersville. The two met at nearby Denison College and fell in love as undergraduates. Interestingly enough, Tess Carlisle was the class president and Jim Carlisle was the lazy lacrosse playing student with the C average. Later in the Rose Garden, the president was able to put aside his recent congressional woes by welcoming these award-winning Girl Scouts to the White House. These young ladies come...
Special bulletin. The president suffered a massive heart attack.
Chiefs of staff, and of course in the front row, there's President's daughter Teresa, her husband. They have two children who live in New York City. And on the other side of Mrs. Carlisle, the President's son Barry, now a very successful businessman in the state of Arizona. Very sad, sad day. Very sad, sad day.
On me.
I did no such thing.
Yes, you did.
I did not.
Where'd you come from?
I came from that gate on the side, and I fully intend to go back the same way.
Mrs. Carlisle.
Wait, please, Mrs. Carlisle. Look, I was wrong.
About a lot of things.
Yes, ma'am, about a lot of things, but I was really wrong about you refusing protection.
No, that's the one thing you were right about. Do you suppose the average taxpayer has any idea how much money is being spent to guard all these old political has-beens and their wives?
No, ma'am,
well, my God, it's an outrage. Cars and the manpower, it just makes me sick.
Listen,
just like Washington to spend money.
Mrs. Carlisle,
like just
please
like
just
Washington.
Talk for 1 second.
About what, Douglas?
About the detail coming back in.
No.
Well, you came out here to ask me something. What was that about?
Well, I was wondering if you'd like to have a cup of coffee.
Oh.
Coffee keeps me awake, Doug, even decaf. I'd like to have a drink. I take a drink occasionally, not often. But... did you know that?
No, ma'am.
Well, I do. If I located a bottle, would you join me in a highball?
Yes, ma'am.
Such a wild and crazy thing. Well, my daughter and I barely speak. Unfortunately, I don't have a much improved relationship with my son. I don't blame them. Oh, the children got screwed. We got the governor's mansion, the Senate, the White House. And they got this very peculiar childhood. I say we. Jim and I were truly partners. You must have known in the White House how much he really depended on me, didn't you?
Yes, ma'am. That was pretty common knowledge.
You must have known about my husband's occasional indiscretions. Didn't think I knew about it, did you? But did you? Nobody thought I knew about it, did they? No. Let's just keep that our little secret.
Yes, ma'am. You can count on me.
I know that. Douglas, we're getting out of here. Well, I've talked about myself enough for one night. Let's talk about you.
Me? Oh, well, there's nothing much to say, man.
Come on, Douglas, of course there is. For instance, what's it like guarding that crazy old bitch, Tess Carlisle?
Mrs. Carlisle, please.
It must get pretty screwy over there, right? The woman lives like a hermit, likes to play golf in a snowstorm. Just the rudimentary facts. Family. Start there.
Family. My father's a retired cop. My mother was a millinery buyer for a small department store.
Married once for 7 months. Come on, Douglas.
You looked into my records.
My husband told me I do not look into people's records. Well, was it painful or a fling?
Everybody seemed to know what she was really like except me.
I'm sorry.
I just don't like people knowing about it because it's embarrassing to me that I was married for such a short time.
You can count on me, Secret Agent Douglas Chesnick.
Special Secret Agent in Charge, Douglas Chesnick.
Well, congratulations, Special Agent Douglas. You've been a very, very naughty boy, but now all is forgiven.
How'd you do it? How'd you talk your way back in here?
Well, Earl, the simple answer is she likes me.
Jimmy, ham and eggs, I think.
Yes, ma'am.
Good morning, gentlemen.
Good morning, Mrs. Carlisle.
Douglas, the president is coming to Somersville. We must prepare for that. Will you have the cars and the machine guns ready in about an hour?
Yes, ma'am.
Good. Thank you. Frederick, perhaps some sit-ups.
Well, I think it's a real feather in our cap to have the president come into the dedication of the final wing.
Do you?
Yes, ma'am.
I think it's a tempest in a teapot, but if the president does insist on coming, what can I do but try to be gracious until the whole affair is over with? Where do you plan to stage this thing, Mr. Porter?
I thought outside at your husband's sepulcher we'd put up a tent.
Well, this is no great concern of mine, and I'm delighted to leave these matters up to you, but if it were me, I'd have the presentation in the reading room with the portrait of my husband as a backdrop, and then I would have refreshments served in the library with a bar set up in the adjoining parlor. What do you think of that, Mr. Porter?
Well, I think that would be nice, too.
Thank you so much again. I suppose you're all excited about the president visiting us poor little country mice.
Oh, yes, ma'am. I see this as a chance to get my people on their toes again, thinking sharp.
So you think they're dull, too?
Frederick.
Tell me, which of these exemplifies elegant disdain yet sincere concern? Good, you know that. You are very good.
I talked to them this morning. We'll have 6 of their guys inside, 10 on the grounds, but we're in charge of the physical plant, okay?
Yeah, all right. Mm-hmm.
Those guys are taking their orders from us.
Does she want to be known today? Don't know her. Don't know her. Don't know her.
It's got no price at all.
Yes, ma'am. Doug, this is Bobby in Canned Goods. Are you anywhere near the manager? I need a price check in Lesore Baby Peas. Repeat, Lesore Baby Peas.
Lesore Baby Peas?
They're on special today, 2 for $59.
They're on special today, 2 for $59.
Copy that. It's 2 for $59.
But I only want one.
Roger that, Doug, but she only wants one.
How much for just one?
The same. It's a 2-for-1 thing.
Bobby, it's a 2-for-1 thing, so I suggest you go ahead and get both.
Copy that, Doug, but I believe we've lost interest in peas. Repeat, lost interest in peas. Canned goods out.
Someone's smoking in here.
Ma'am?
Dude, someone is smoking in a grocery store. Are you going to deal with this?
yes, ma'am.
Okay, I want one of those temporary rinses, not blue hair.
Yes, ma'am.
It's blue, I'll just chop it all off.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, let's do it.
I suppose you better give it to her. You're her secretary.
Oh, I love this color. Come in.
Mrs. Carlisle?
Douglas! Hello, come on, we're back here.
Mrs. Carlisle?
Yes, come in, come in.
I think you look beautiful.
Oh. Thank you.
I've got a fax here from Washington.
Uh-huh.
It's confidential.
Oh, please excuse us for just a moment.
Yes, ma'am.
The president's not coming. Pressing matters of state.
Well, we can relax then.
Yes, ma'am.
Will he be sending someone in his place?
Yes, ma'am. Secretary of Commerce, Yvonne Boyer.
Excellent. That'll make your job a lot easier.
Yes, ma'am.
Would you be kind enough to send the hairdresser back in so she can collect her things?
Yes, ma'am.
The thing that my husband would be particularly proud of is that this center is a place of learning and contemplation. He would have liked that very, very much. What I am especially proud of is that we took a fine, wonderful old building and we made it useful again. That appeals to me. Perhaps because I'm getting old myself. Well, in closing, I would like to thank Yvonne Kiki Hernandez Boye for taking time out of her nonstop hectic schedule to be here with us today. Thank you so much, Kiki, for coming. You honor us all with your gracious, gracious company.
Yes, ma'am.
I'd like to go on a picnic tomorrow down by the lake.
Yes, ma'am. They say it might snow tomorrow.
Well, we can't just wait on summer, now can we?
Well, I guess not.
I'd very much appreciate it if I could go with just you and not everyone else.
Yes, ma'am. Is this better than Mr. Wren? Mrs. Carlyle, I think it's getting colder.
Would you leave me alone, please?
Yes, ma'am. Mrs. Carlyle? Ma'am? Thank you.
Office.
Are they back yet?
Doug?
Yeah. Doug, are they there?
Who? Mrs. Carlisle?
Yes.
No, they're not here. Aren't they with you?
No. Call everybody in. Come get me.
Back yet?
Nope. When did they take off?
About 2.5 hours ago.
Jesus.
Who's this? Tom, they there? Okay, call Sheriff Jansen and the Highway Patrol. Tell them they're just out joyriding again. It's not a problem, but inform them that there's no security with Mrs. Carlisle. Okay, thanks.
Washington?
No, not yet. We'll give him another hour.
Okay.
God damn her for this.
Okay, Barbara. Let's call Washington. This is the worst moment of my life.
She was taken. The people who did it must have been setting this up for months.
Yes, sir.
Did you notice anything suspicious at all?
No, sir.
Nothing at all?
No, sir.
I ought to call the president when we get to the Carlisle place.
Yes, sir. It'll be almost midnight by then, Mr. Harrison.
That's no problem. He's up.
Thanks for coming in.
Sure.
Excuse me. I would appreciate it if you'd put something under there so that we don't scratch the table.
Doug, why don't you come in here with me?
That's correct.
Doug, this is Charles Ivey, CIA. Doug here is agent in charge for Mrs. Carlisle.
Mr. President, I've got Agent Doug Chestnick with me. Uh-huh. Yeah?
Does he want to speak with me?
No.
She has a full-time nurse. What's that for?
She's had some dizziness the last couple years. And he monitors her medication, makes sure she's eating right, that kind of stuff.
7 well-trained, heavily armed men can't take care of one little old lady. You disgust me.
Yes, sir.
Doug, Sheriff Jansen's on the phone.
Who's that?
Local sheriff.
What's he got?
It's for Agent Chesnick. Doug, why don't you take him to the kitchen?
Christian agent Dennis.
Thank you.
They found the car on a country road. Driver unconscious on the front seat. He's being taken to a county hospital. Mrs. Carlisle was not at the scene.
Jesus Christ.
Mr. President, Tess Carlisle has been kidnapped.
I thought you'd appreciate an update.
A plastic syringe was found on the floor of the front seat. Lab says it contains a combination of extremely powerful drugs.
Ketamine and Ativan? Both are common, they're easy to steal. And used together would knock out a full-grown man within 10 seconds of being injected. A big enough shot would keep him down for up to 6-7 hours, which squares with how long your guy was out. We take it as a good sign that they used the drug instead of killing him. The injuries on the back of the driver's neck, by the way, are burns, which is interesting. They're both in the shape of a small crescent, a little smaller than a quarter. My friends from the CIA think it might be a brand, a signature kind of thing for a Middle Eastern terrorist organization.
Also, we spoke to Mrs. Carlisle's doctor. Those pills that she takes for dizziness. Actually, it's a little more serious than that.
She has an inoperable brain tumor. Did any of you know that?
Well, anyway, we'll have fiber and fingerprint reports by late afternoon. And a note was found in the car's glove compartment. Demanding $15 million. Well, that's about it. Except we're going to need these offices. You can all go home if you want to. That's the best thing to do, I think. Thanks.
Well, let's get any personal stuff and get out.
What's with that nonsense about Middle Eastern terrorists? Can you imagine a bunch of Arabs slipping around Somersville unnoticed for even 10 minutes?
Yeah, what about this plastic syringe in the back of the car? Does that bother anybody else? I mean, if these guys are such accomplished pros, what would they be doing leaving something like that behind? It had to be left there on purpose.
Yeah. How long has she been gone?
22 hours and 30 minutes.
Doug, can I get a ride with you?
Yes.
Mrs. Carlisle hired me.
I know, Kimberly. We'll find her.
When others wouldn't.
Douglas, which is correct, okay?
I just want you to think about this. Mrs. Carlisle is sitting in the backseat of the Lincoln, right? Now, if she's been taken off against her will, you know this particular woman's not just going to sit there and take that. She's going to take some form of action. So what does she have in the backseat in the way of a weapon?
I don't know.
Cigarette lighter. Right there in the door. Makes a little round crescent-shaped burn.
How's it going? You getting anywhere?
We'll know more when all the lab stuff comes in.
Yeah, well, if there's anything I can do, Mr. Schaefer, or Doug, just ask me.
Thank you.
Earl, can we have a look at your neck?
Yeah, I guess we'll for.
Well, it's just such a peculiar thing.
Oh.
Let me get a nurse to help with the bandage.
What's this about?
He just wants to see the burns. He thinks they're the key to this case.
The burns?
Yeah.
See, I already told him. I don't know how they got there because I was unconscious.
Could you sit up, please?
Okay.
What do you think?
About the burns?
Yeah.
Well, we got a couple ideas.
Like what?
Just ideas.
Thank you. Well, I certainly hope you're not going to try to pin this on me. I mean, I certainly wasn't the one who arranged for Mrs. Carlyle to be out in the middle of nowhere and guarded by only one agent. That certainly was not my idea. And I also wasn't the one who hated Mrs. Carlyle with a vengeance. That was Agent Chesnick here. Did he tell you that?
Is that right? You hated her?
With a vengeance.
I actually like her very much.
I mean, ask anybody. They argued all the time. Isn't that right, Doug? I mean, isn't that right?
Is that normal for an agent to be arguing with us?
No.
No, of course it's not. See, you should be asking him the questions. Hated her guts, true or false? Look. She treated these guys like dirt. You know what I mean? She threw them all out of the house a couple of weeks ago. Can I have a cigarette?
Sorry, don't smoke. Why are you suddenly so upset, Mr. Fowler?
I'm not upset. Well, wouldn't you be? Look, I may be only the driver, but I'm at least smart enough to know that you guys are not going to leave town without putting somebody in jail, and that somebody doesn't have to be guilty, right? I mean, I read, I know how you guys operate.
You did it, didn't you?
Hey, the hell with you, okay, Dougie?
It was easy, wasn't it?
Will you get him out of my face? I mean, I'm not putting up with this. I don't have to take this.
All right.
Okay?
Okay.
Okay.
I'm going to have to warn you, Mr. Fowler, that the FBI does now consider you a suspect.
Well, okay, that's just terrific.
And I mean, I suggest you get a lawyer as soon as you possibly can.
Don't you worry about that. I'm going to protect myself.
Where is she, Earl?
Speak to my lawyer, Agent Dougie.
All right, that's it for now. Well, no more questions, but we're going to have you available to us, Mr. Fowler, at our convenience. All right? Oh, no, Doug. Let's not be stupid here, all right?
Where is she?
I don't know.
Doug, we're the good guys, okay? We don't do stuff like this.
Look at that, don't you get it? Don't you get it? I'm the only witness you've got. He wants to kill me. Good God, doesn't that tell you anything?
Come on, Doug. I'm telling you to holster your pistol. Oh,
Jesus, help me.
God damn it, Doug, put that gun away. You're already in so much trouble.
He's gonna tell me. Tell you what, I don't know anything.
Even if he does, we can't use it. Not like this!
Earl, I'm going to count to five, and then I'm going to shoot one of your toes off.
Oh, God!
Doug.
And then I'm going to count to five and shoot another toe.
Doug!
Listen, I don't know anything. Will you just get that through your thing? Ah!
Ah! Ah! Are you crazy? Ah! Are you?
He didn't count!
Five.
He didn't even count!
Four.
You're going to prison, Doug.
Listen to me! Will you just listen to me? If he is involved.
This is the nurse's station. Should we call the police?
Yes, ma'am, any FBI.
If he is involved, then she knows it. And if she knows it, her life is worthless. You understand me? They have to fucking kill her. We don't have time to meet his lawyer, right, Earl?
Oh, God, help me.
Five.
Doug,
Four!
No! No! Oh, come
three,
on! Okay!
Two!
Okay! 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 Look, they've got her in an abandoned farmhouse! Okay!
An abandoned farmhouse?
Yeah! Yeah!
I don't think so.
No! Five. No, I swear to God! I swear to God! Doug, really, listen, it's my sister and her husband. Check it out, Doug. It wasn't my idea. I swear to God. They made me do it. Oh, Mrs. Carlisle's all right, Doug, because my sister was taking very good care of her.
Sunset tomorrow
about 4:15. Freeze!
Go! No, that's it! You have the right to remain silent!
Over here.
Where?
There. She's down there.
What?
Take that off.
You buried her?
Jesus Christ.
Is she alive?
Yeah. Pretty sure.
You put her down there, what? Over 30 hours ago? This is not a young woman. You guys better start saying your prayers.
What?
What did you do? What did you do?
Take it easy!
Get him off!
Get him off!
Get him the hell out of here!
Look how deep this is. They weren't going to dig this woman up. Keep her alive for a day or two in case you had to have her. Just cut the ventilation. Walk. Who the hell let you back in?
We want to do the digging. She's our responsibility.
You guys are upset. Wait outside. Let people who know how to do this do it. Okay, okay. All right, dig. Guys, come on. Get out of there. Give these men the shovels. Come on.
All yours. Thank you.
Give me the shovel.
Something.
Pull up the pipe, Stevens.
Is she down there?
Mrs. Carlisle? Ma'am?
Somebody get a power saw!
Got it!
Come on, move!
I want soap, water, and blankets. Nobody sees her like this.
Okay.
Chesnick!
Doug Chesnick!
Doug Chesnick!
Doug Chesnick!
I'm Chesnick. What is it?
Lady's awake, sir. Says she's not going anywhere without her secret service detail. Is that you guys?
Yeah, that's us.
And you come aboard, sir.
Yeah, we can do that.
Wait 1 second, sir. I'm sorry, gentlemen. I'm going to have to throw some of you off.
Looking for you.
How long did it take you to figure out the cigarette lighter burns?
About 22 hours.
Oh, Douglas, it was so obvious.
No, it wasn't. Actually, I was the only one who got it.
Oh, I can hardly believe that.
It's true.
Howard Schaefer, Mrs. Carlisle, FBI. If I may say, ma'am, Agent Chesnick is the reason we found you. If he hadn't shot a man in the hospital today.
Shot a man?
Yes, ma'am.
You finally got to shoot somebody, huh, Douglas?
Well...
Oh, did you kill him?
Shot him in the toe.
Oh, after all that practice.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, if I could set the record straight.
Excuse me, I'd just like to talk to this gentleman, if you don't mind.
I'll get it, dear. Tell the others I'll be out in a minute.
Yes, ma'am.
Hello?
Mrs. Carlisle, the president's returning your call.
Oh, yes, thank you.
Yes, ma'am.
Tess, are they treating you all right in that hospital? Because if they're not...
Harold, I want this Secret Service agent of mine taken care of.
Tess, the man discharged a firearm in a public place.
I don't care about any of that. This young man saved my life. He's like a son to me, Harold. I want him taken care of, you understand?
Well, sure, Tess. I'm sure we...
Oh, and if anything should ever happen to me, I want your personal word that you will look after him.
Well, sure, Tess. You know, I...
Good. Thanks, Harold. That's all I wanted to know. You have yourself a nice day.
Yes, ma'am.
Dr. Willis to 4 West Nurses Station. Dr. Willis to 4 West Nurses Station.
What is this?
It's your wheelchair, ma'am.
I can see it's a wheelchair, but I won't be needing it. Thank you very much.
Well, it's hospital policy that you leave by wheelchair.
No, but I would really prefer not to sit in the wheelchair. I would much rather walk on my own 2 feet with my own steam out of the hospital.
I understand, but the rules and regulations state that each patient must leave in a wheelchair.
No. Rules and regulations, young man, are not something I'm terribly fond of. So if you would just allow me to go out on my own...
Mrs. Carlisle, I'm just trying to do my job.
Ms. Carlisle,
please,
I'm
only trying to do my...
If I may,
just let me do my...
If I may interrupt... The regulations aren't really that sacred, are they? And Tess... Get in the goddamn chair.
Very good, Douglas. You're going to be all right. Very good.
Thank you.